And although the Democrat Senate has known for many months that on July 1st, many student loans, federal student loans, would double, they've been more involved in internal bickering rather than actually addressing the issue. And the students that are surrounded with us today, they're all suffering because of it. One example is a gal from Eastern Washington, Haley Homan. She's working at a local McDonald's drive-thru in Eastern Washington to help pay for rising tuition at Washington State University. And when she heard that the loans, her federal loans, may be doubling, she's an aspiring economist, maybe a public servant, she's not sure she'll be able to finish school. And unfortunately, that is repeated among many students all across this country. I was the first in my family to graduate from college and graduate school, still paying off some of those student loans myself. And I can tell you firsthand how difficult it is at times to pay those tuition rates. And it's not fair for Democrats who run Washington to stand in these students' way. On any given year, about 20 million students are in college, and 60% of them have to take out student loans. So when Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid tells us that he's not looking for a compromise, I would encourage him to think about Haley, think about these college students, think about millions of others across the country. As members of Congress, we're here to make life easier for students that want to go to college, want to get an education, want to find a job. And instead, we see just the opposite. We see fighting internally instead of passing a solution. I urge them to act quickly to put students first, not Washington politics.
You know, Republicans have acted to stop student loans interest rates from doubling and to make college more affordable for students across the country, including these students that are right here behind me. The White House and Senate Democrats have let these students down. Frankly, I think they deserve better. It's time for the president to lead. It's time for him to bring Senate Democrat leaders together and develop a solution. The House has done its job. It's time for the Senate and the White House to do its job. And if you look at what the House passed, it's very close to what the president offered in his own budget earlier this year. Listen, the failure to lead on student loans is part of the president's larger issue, and that is the failure to lead on the biggest issues facing our country, jobs and the economy. Every American deserves better than this new normal of slow economic growth, not enough jobs, and no increase in wages.
I want to be very direct. The House has acted to stop the rate from being doubled. The Senate had failed to act, and now the rates have doubled. Who gets hurt? The students with us and the students across America. They don't care about Republicans and Democrats. They want to have a fighting chance for a future. So we ask Harry Reid, take an action. Don't stop the ability for a compromise. America is looking at him, and the students, most importantly, are. Don't punish them for his inaction.
My colleagues have pointed out the problem. July 1st, it's behind us now, the interest rates on subsidized Stafford student loans doubled. The House passed legislation to keep that from happening, to tie student loan interest rates to the market, to the 10-year Treasury, to make a long-term solution and get politicians out of the business of setting the interest rate every election year. The White House has proposed a similar solution. A bipartisan group of senators in the Senate have proposed a similar solution. And yet, there's no action from the Senate Majority Leader. It is time for Senate Democrats to step up, take action, get a long-term solution, and give these students the surety and the relief that they need.